big hit happens, and I quickly remember that I did this for the majority of my youth, from the age of 7 all the way through like 20 years old. And now I look at them like, man, that's crazy what they do out there, man. And for a woman to get out there? Nah, I just can't see it. Andre Elam says, tip female boxers against females. Did somebody say, well, they got female boxers? Yeah, they do. Female boxers against female boxers. They already got woman on woman or women on women football. They do. They already have that. The lingerie league, they actually go out there and hit. You know, and it might be, you know, kind of, what's the term I used earlier? It's kind of misogynistic for this women's lingerie league. You know, it's kind of, you know, I get it. You know, it's kind of sexist, I guess. But it's women on women. It's not women on men. No, I mean, the best lingerie league football players, they don't want to run up against no darn, you know, Julius Peppers type cat. I don't care how strong they are. Men are made differently than women, period. I grab my wife and I hug my wife. She's like, ooh, she's so soft and cuddly. She's so soft and cuddly. Like, she's just soft, like mushy. Like, I push in her arm and my finger go halfway in. Man, there's some dudes out here, man. Myself as well, in relative terms to being a 47-year-old man. Some dudes out here, man, who just made a, like, block and steel. I mean, they so goddamn hard. Nah. No, I don't think so. From T, not sorry, Dub, woman on woman. I like how that sounds. You're a comedian now. T-Dub still got his profile pic held over from yesterday. Oh, the great Coco. This Coco chick, man, Ice-T old lady, I said this before. It might be partially fake, but this Coco chick got one of the baddest bodies to ever walk the face of the earth. From Tiffany Poole in Portland, you don't think Layla Ali can whoop 95% of the dudes in this chat? She's a licensed boxer. Her speed alone in her prime would catch y'all. Listen, I like Layla Ali, and if you don't know the story, we had a little run-in in the studio many years ago. She had that same attitude that she could whoop somebody up in that studio, and such is not the case. As I always say, if I hit Layla Ali in her darn kidney, it's a wrap. She came in there with this little attitude. I don't even remember what it was, but she was in studio with her boyfriend. I've told this story before. And she came in there all smart mouth and, you know, in effect, I don't know if she was playing and marketing her next fight, trying to promote her next fight or whatever, but she was talking kind of slick to your boys. Yeah, she was talking kind of slick. I can't remember exactly what the conversation was. I'm like, Layla Ali, listen, you fight women, you know, and I'm not a professional boxer or anything. But I'm from the country, and I'm country strong. And if I punch your ass in your side, you're going to go down. Right. You're going to go down. You're going to go down. And her husband was in there. It was a dude named Lala Arara. Can't remember his name. They divorced now. And, you know, he was her manager or whatever. And I kept saying to myself, man, you better get your chick. You better get your chick. Yeah. Yeah, so if Layla Ali get in a ring with a dude, okay, I mean, what's her weight class? So she probably about 150, maybe 150 pounds, maybe 160 pounds, maybe a little bit bigger. So 160 pounds, you're talking about like welterweights. You're talking about her getting in the ring with, you know, an older, you know, a little bit heavier Marvin Hagler or Sugar Ray Leonard or Tommy Hearns. Man, please. Man, come on. If I'm trying to figure out a weight class. Say if she was 160 pounds. 160-pound professional boxer? Layla Ali, I'm sorry. You may whip many chicks' asses. But you ain't getting in no ring with no professional boxer your same weight. And expect to survive. Not just win, but survive. Your ass going to the emergency room for a long time. From loose-necked, homosexual side, Doug jumped, but jumped by Brittany Griner behind the pump. You stupid. Thorny switch. Now, I do think Layla could whoop most in here, but a Layla in her prime against, say, Tyson in his prime will not end well for her. From Derek. She spells Derek with an A. Layla Ali equals Vera slash Doug equals quick. I don't even know what that means, sir. I'm lost. From Big John B, I would knock Layla out today in her prime and in her prime. Marvin Hagler versus Layla Ali. Right. I mean, look up the great Marvin Hagler. I'm going to do another search. I'm sorry. This is why we need that $4, man, so we can get more production value up in here. So Marvin Hagler fought at, do they have his weight class? No, they don't. And you're listening to the Doug Stewart Show. Let me look at his box rec, his boxing record. They usually show the weight class that they fight in. So Marvin Hagler fought at his last fights that he had. He fought at, and it doesn't show it. I apologize. He fought at middleweight. So middleweight is, and you're listening to the Doug Stewart Show. So the middleweight division in boxing is, So that's a little bit bigger. So whatever the division is below middleweight, probably welterweight, I don't know. I'm not going to look up another one. I'm guessing somewhere about 160. So I would guess that Layla Ali probably was fighting at probably 150 maybe. She's a big chick. You don't want no dudes like that in no boxing ring. And once again, shouts out to all of the ladies that are physically fit and like sports and whatever. Boxing another dude in a boxing match and playing football against another dude in football, don't see that happen. I know we're progressive as hell in women's rights and all of that. I even have Woman Wednesday. But that ain't going to happen. Let me grab a call. Caller, thanks for calling the Doug Stewart Show. What's your name? Where you calling from? What you want to talk about?
Doug Stewart, what's that?
What's up? Who's this?
T from Huntsville, sir.
T from Huntsville, what up, baby?
Oh, man, enjoying the show as always, man. I know you made a close it out, man. Hey, man, I want to address something, a slight travesty you were discussing earlier.
Hold on a second, T. T, first of all, man, thanks for your contribution to the Stewart Media and Entertainment Network, man. I've been listening to your show, and you didn't threaten the lives of every white person within range of you. So you haven't gone there yet, so I'm happy, T. You're doing a great job, man. Thank you, bro.
Hey, I appreciate that, man. I'm just trying to be just a little bit like you, man. You know, I can't do it for real. You know what I'm saying? We just all trying to mimic you a little bit. But I appreciate the platform, though, man.
That's what's up. What you got?
Hey, man, your list about, I refer to them as top pipeline songs.
Right.
But could I give you five quick ones in no particular order?
Okay, so if you're just joining into the show, when you're listening to the Doug Stewart Show earlier, we started talking about Shy and If I Ever Fall in Love Again, that track from 1993. And I said that was the theme song to me and my old lady's side riding days in college.
Yeah.
And so I said Shy would be in my top five, and I couldn't think of any other songs off the top of my head. So let me hear your list, T.
Okay. And again, top five is, you know, it's hard to say because there's so many good cuts. And let me say that quick before I do this is it really depends on what you were going through in your time period. But for me, Silk, Lose Control.
Okay, that's good.
Keep Sweat, I'll Give All My Love to You.
Oh, man, I forgot about the great Keith Sweat. You could probably get like three or four from Keith Sweat. Okay, I like that.
Yeah. R. Kelly, Sex Me.
Okay.
I was a junior in high school when 12 Play dropped. I mean, it's debauchery, as you would say, sir, debauchery.
Right.
And Isley Brothers, and I got this from somebody in the chat because I was going to say Living for the Love of You. But Between the Sheets is more appropriate.
Between the Sheets. The Isley Brothers.
And this last one is, again, when I was coming up and around the time I had a car.
Hold on, Jodeci, Love You for Life. Hold on a second.
Yeah.
So the last one you said, the studio audience was clapping. Your last one was Jodeci, Love You for Life?
Yeah, Jodeci, Love You for Life.
Oh, man. That's an impressive list, T. That's an impressive list.
Yeah,
thank you, bro.
Hey, no problem, man. Hey, one side note, Escape made better slow songs than Shatter, and I'm gone.
I'm sorry? Say that one more time. I'm sorry? What was that one more time, T? I didn't even hear what he had to say. Keith Sweat, whatever Keith Sweat song he said, fantastic. R. Kelly, 12 Play, I think he said. Isley Brothers, Between the Sheets. Hey, girl, ain't no mystery. Has he? As far as I can see, I want to keep you here. Laying next to me. As we make sweet love between the sheets. Ding, ding, ding. Baby, baby, I feel your love surrounding me. Ooh, ooh, ooh. Baby, baby, making love between the sheets. Perfect way to end today's show.
When Tupac was around, he wanted to raise a nation of thugs.
Yes, sir.
But,
yes, sir.
I think it's only right for me to raise a nation of bruh.
Uh-huh.
Frank Cole, Ernie Jess.
Yeah.
Oscar Cooper.
Shouts out to Terradome 32. The last of the lamps. Shouts out to my man Pink Gator for this hot ass Q track.
Ernest Chess.
Yeah.
Oscar Cooper.
Shouts out to my man Waterhand, Walter, Pole Politicking, Engineers, Dwayne Bassan, Gerald Oliveri, the consultant, Brandon Butler. Thank you very much. Hold on. My favorite part of this song is coming up. Hold on.
In that pack over there, that my dog team. Before I came out the womb, I had purple dreams.
Uh-huh. Schizo, that my line game.
That my chain game.
Yeah.
My yard, to any yard.
Hey, special thank you to all of the Stewies, man. Without you, there is no me. Thank you very much. All right, we're going to do it again tomorrow. Same Doug Stewart time, same Doug Stewart channel. Be careful in them streets. Peace.
And we gonna run the ship. The greatest threat on the planet Earth. But make no mistake, God, I put you first. See, I know my place. And I stand my ground. Cues in the sky. We gonna hold it down. Frank Cole, Ernest Jess, Oscar Cooper, Edgar Love.
Do the dog catch a baby, do the dog catch a
dog.